Right, so this time it won't be another part of the guides for the Old World Blues. Although I don't think if I even plan to finish the guide for the Brotherhood of Steel. At this video I will be talking about the sub-mode to the Old World Blues that's called a Hellfire, which adds a playable nation of Vault 103. It's basically a robotic nation that relies on the slavery or the use of the massive use of the robots. And its main team lies in its demonic appearance, behavior, and such things. It's even placed in between countries, like countries, factions like High Chapel, Heaven's Gate, Murtal, Reformers, Bond Dancers, and such. And all of them have a religious teams, so Harbinger with Legion of Hell fights to it quite nicely. At the beginning I want to address that it won't be as much as of a review, more like my opinion about this sub-mode overall. I will try to touch as much of the elements that this sub-mode brings, but it won't be like structured in any way, so whatever will came to my mind, or like I will remind myself during the video, I will try to talk about it as it goes. So yeah, basically you have you get access to the this unique new faction that sadly doesn't fare too well if a player isn't playing as one, so it's like a first thing that you will notice whenever you are playing like any country. You will quickly notice that world like disappears quite quickly, just because it either peaks wrong focuses, or like AI can't handle the correct order of doing things on this faction. And it's one of the challenges that is playing as Legion of Hell, is that you are tied to your decisions, especially like early on, and you need to pick like kind of mic-maxing them in order to like deal with the early threats, especially the troll warrens that if they manage to get big can be quite problematic. And if new Renault turns into the Trats Legion, like it's just impossible to win against them, and that get climbs and focuses against you quite quickly, so it can be over quite soon. In this playthrough I had quite a lack, because a Mirelurk tribe managed to kind of overthrow them when they were in the war against me. Quite luckily no Trats Legion was formed during this war, but the early game is very tough, I think, but it's doable. Like, you can win those wars. That's why you have all those focuses, one, and that helps you in this effort in one way or another. But this mod doesn't let you go of your mistakes quite easily. Basically, one wrong declaration of war or horrible timing can end your walkthrough quite quickly. When it comes to the late game, they scale very well, especially the more production, the more robots you can get, the stronger this faction will get, as an army. But they do have access to unique robotic tech, especially C-22, which is kinda RNG or time gated. I don't know if devs know how it works, then they can always clarify how this event triggers. But you can get this in the mid game to the late game, and it's quite awesome to have those robots as your main force. When it comes to the infantry, you won't be relying on it at all, because you are very limited when it comes to the infantry equipment, training and such. Support equipment, of course you can get quite advanced things, but I didn't really bother with it at all. At some point, I'd even forget about researching things from it. When it comes to the vehicles, you don't get any. When it comes to the robots, you can get all sorts of the robotic tech. Also, if you have noticed, there is a custom icons for the each kind of the robot, which is quite nice. And they look quite interesting, like submodifier Mr. Handy, modified Mr. Handy, or those Protectrons that have their unique demonic flavor. When it comes to the land doctrine, it's an interesting thing that I will be talking quite soon. When it comes to the special warfare thing, it's didn't fucking bother because I didn't have to. When it comes to the air, didn't bother with it at all as well. Maybe it was a mistake, but if I managed to win all my wars without that, then perhaps it was not. Naval technologies and naval overall, I don't fucking care really about it, and it's not unique in any way, so never mind. When it comes to the production, they have access to the advanced building technologies and resources. But what's interesting, it's maybe oversight, or maybe I picked a wrong focus, which can be a case. They don't have access to the unique vault tech, which is kinda weird because it's a vault, so they should have it. At least Blue Rose Society has access to it, and I didn't manage to see any vault there at all. But I don't know, maybe it's because I did pick it. Maybe because of the choice of focus that moves your capital from the vault to the Troll Warrens and renames it Hell's Deep. But maybe, I don't know. When it comes to the encryption and communication and stuff like that, you can get everything to the advanced level, which is kind of obvious. Here it presents overall how the tech levels are presented. Basically nothing in the infantry, special forces and sparse tribal vehicles. Can't search even bikes. So that's basically it. Let's talk about the focuses. So at the start you get a first batch of the focuses that talks about like lore about of the place that you are starting in. It's quite nice written all through. It's some point like a little bit too edgy, at least for my taste. But it also gives you access to the early modifiers and bonuses. Some of them are quite nice and strong. Some of them are like better the later you get into the game. But in all honesty, for this phase you kinda need to min-max in order to get everything going quite quickly. Then you have access to the like more open part of the tech tree. Left part is about industry. You can get your industry slave based or robotic based. Each of them has its own unique patches and focuses. So you can like customize it even more depending on your preferences. I went for the slavery patch that has a ties with the Legion and gives you and the Legion bonuses and debuffs based if they like agree for it or not. In my case, they managed to agree with me for the slave trade, so they get like some percent bonuses to resources, I think, but I am not sure. Then you have a middle part. Middle part is like sieves and arms factories. It's always nice, but like nothing special. Then you have like a finishing focus that you can make after Masters of the World or Army of the Demons. Some of like one of those focuses gives you access to the finishing focus of the industry tech. Then you have a part that basically is about your leader, Harbinger. You can get rid of some debuffs and reinforce your leader with additional stability, war support, and such things like that. New reserve slot, new advisors, and things like that are tied to this part. Then you have focuses related to the energy supply. You can pick the way how you want to approach to that. You can also get like nice bonuses out of it. Then you have on your right side a military branch, and it's quite well done. You can get either a classic robotic tech and focuses related to that. So you can get for the standard robotic warfare doctrine if you prefer that, or you can go for quite unique a terror-based doctrine that has some nice timed debuffs for the enemy for even fighting you, and then you are getting buffs to your units. I prefer to go for the left side just for the novelty and uniqueness. Like, you can win those wars later on even without any of those, so why not? Then you can get a finishing focus after getting Age of Demons as well. So both of those branches like offer some finishing after progressing further below. Then you have quite nice sub-branch related to the demonic princess and stuff like that. Each of them gives like some debuff, not debuff, some buff to you and your nation, additional political power, consumer goods, and stuff like that. So it's also quite nice. When it comes to the expansion of your territories, I think it's one of the strongest points of this mod. As you can approach to your yearly expansion in your own unique way. While Camel Station is kind of straightforward in its approach, start from the border conflict, then proceed to the all in warfare. Bomb Dancer and Sochans have their own approaches. For the Sochans, you can pick either if you want a puppet or you want to start border conflicts against them. In my experience, the border conflicts are the best choice, as the puppet path is kinda underwhelming, at least for now. Basically, when the puppet spawns, like perhaps two squads of infantry are spawned for the Sochans that are on your side, and the problem is that they don't even bother with defending their capital, so they capitulate quickly. Your forces suddenly get either surrounded by the defenders or stay forward, just push out. So it's completely not worth it to go, at least for now, and it's like trap. If bot picks that path, then it's like sure, they will get destroyed soon after. When it comes to the bond dancers, it's mostly tied to what they pick for their focuses. Sadly, it's so early on in the focus tree that each time I have picked a gang of raiders path, as they didn't manage to reach for either of those focuses to make it like any more unique, so that's it. After finishing your war with each of them, you get a reduces costs for currying their states, which is knights, and a occurring term of this mode. Like after beating every country, you get those bonuses to the reduce cost of the currying. Then you can get rid of the minor countries around you, which is Klamath, Maru Drinkers, High Chapel, and Murta Sinners. So you can like expand even further. Then you have a encounter with the Troll Warrens, assuming like they managed to survive. In my case, they each time managed to survive and expand quite quickly. Although in this walkthrough, Mirelurk tribe was strong enough that they put a quite of resistance to the Troll Warren. They went in there, were against me in the same time, and it's basically it for them. After this, you have like some focuses related to this war, but they are like nothing to talk special about. Some bonuses, which are quite nice. Then you have a decision after defeating them if you want to move your capital to the Troll Warrens and rename it, or you want to stay in the vault. And this is the part where maybe if I picked the vault path, it could give me a industrial vault technology. If not, then I don't know, maybe it's oversight. After which you get a part of the focuses, which focuses on the war against every bigger neighbor that you have. So Washington Brotherhood, New California, Legion, another part of the Brotherhood, and so on and so on. The most interesting part of this focus tree lies in the branches to the left and the right. The left one allows you to contact with the big empty scientists and reinstate them as a country on the Mohave territories, and rename them as the Masterminds. Then on the right you have a Texas Super Mutants and the Demon's Attorney focuses, but I couldn't finish them because at this point they were long gone, so I don't really know what it gives to you, except that it's related to them. After beating all those enemies and finishing their focuses and opening the gates of hell, which is a special thing for Legion of Hell, you get a focus, this world is conquered, and you get a claim for basically everything on the map. But at this point I consider the game as finished, as you can see I am currently in this state, and I don't have strength or the willpower to fight against the Tlaloxon. Like, fuck this, and fuck struggling with each single river, each single point where they can like invade behind your lines and shit like. I could win it this easily with the amount of forces I have, but it's micromanaging, and it's the worst form of the micromanaging. But sure, if somebody wants to have like Legion of Hell on the whole map, sure, go for it. But for me, it's like finished campaign already. When it comes to the Gates of Hell, it's a unique thing for the Harbinger, which basically gives you an option to sacrifice your population in your states and your civilian factories production in order to finish a constructions, after which you get an event to open those gates, and then you have a decision what to do next. And quite honestly, I found this part quite disappointing, especially the opening part and what was next. Like, I don't know. I won't spoil it for you, but it won't be as like ground shattering as you might expect. One of the most interesting parts of this in this sub mode lies in the unique events. Like, you can get a C-22 robotic platform at some point that pops up in the mid to late game. I don't know what like triggers it, but sure. You can also have to deal with something that it's called a holy mercenaries or like something like that. Basically, you get a four characters, each with their own lore. I'm like admiring the amount of work that creators put into those events and like writing all those things about those characters. But you get like those four mercenaries that are effectively sabotaging your production and stuff like that quite regularly, and you can eliminate them by setting traps against them or like luring them out. And it's quite interesting, because while first one you can just like set a trap by picking right decision, the other one, as example, requires you to fire up a civil war. Like, you need to stage a civil war which lasts out one of those saboteurs. So you can like win against them and then eliminate one of those. Then you have to like wait until one of them makes a fails move and also gets killed, and then you have a focus to not focus decision to kill their leader, and basically that's finishes this part of like small arc of the storyline, if you can like call it a storyline. For everything I think this mode has like quite rough start that requires you to basically pick only the best option and options, unless you want like extra unnecessary challenge. Then it like ramps up in the power quite nicely up until the point where game starts to be tedious, but it's not a problem of the mod, of the submodes itself. It's like the problem of scale of the conflicts and how like all of this is solved. Like, I don't have problems with those little checkpoints and shit. I have problems with the fact that I have to micromanage every single of them, and the lines, the front lines aren't like assigning to them properly. So each time like my forces get to this point, I have to disassemble, like select them, assign them to their own corresponding tiles, and then like keep moving. And like those impassable mountains were interesting at this scale. Is like fucking nightmare to micromanage, and I can't be bothered with this crap at this point. But yeah, the later in the game, the stronger they get, and like while it's case for every country, the Legion of Hell scales particularly well. They have low coring costs for like most of the territories. They have quite nice industry with their focuses, so you can like pump out those robots. Like currently, I don't fucking even know how many factories are pumping out those robots, but they're just not ending, at least for me. So I could like spawn another shit ton of those robots and throw them like whatever. No, not even care about losses, because recruit population, at least for me, for now, it's like surpassing every kind of losses that I can like ever get against Son of the Tlaloc. But yeah, it's a good sub-mode that could have some polishes in some places, like as example the session part. Also, I think that bots should get some handicap buffs, or like, you know, I don't know, spawn divisions, like whatever, to help it win against its neighbors. It should probably have a blocked focuses that are killing it. Maybe, I don't know, set path how they should approach it to have a fair fight. Because let's face it, they just can't handle, like AI can't handle this faction at all, and you have to play them themselves to experience in its all glory. I think that is basically it. I don't know what I like should have. Maybe at some point I will make a video about how to play as the Legion of Hell. But for now, I think that I am like done with this faction, and I'm going to like play something different on the map. At least for now, I don't know. So yeah, that's it. Thank you for listening. And take care.